Benny, welcome to the show.
Yes, thank you for having me. It's exciting stuff. You know.
Yeah, if you don't mind me asking, what? What's going on? What's up?
Well, it's just as simple, you know, I was outside, you know, I knew it was coming to the show. It's Rockefeller Center,
a lot of
tourists out there. So I figured I'd take advantage of the opportunity and just do some side work, you know?
Oh, perfect.
And I just didn't have a lot of time to change it because you have to do a daylight savings and all that stuff.
I appreciate you making the time to be on the show.
This is awesome.
You've been part of some incredible films. And before you were a director and an actor, you were also a stand-up comedian.
Yes. Actually, you know, I have a deep respect for stand-up comedy because you really are out there with no net whatsoever.
Yeah.
And it really was kind of the first time in high school I started doing it. You know, it was really the first time I was trying to express myself.
What was your act like?
And I would go on as character. You know, I had two characters. I started out as Zachary Mulden. That was the first guy I did.
The name of your actor, Zachary Mulden?
Zachary Mulden.
Wow.
Yes. And he was kind of just this... He was more of a surreal comedy. The first joke I came out with was like a really big hit, actually. I would come out with like a yarmulke and a big beard, and I would say, "Hey, everybody, I'm Jewish." And I'd take it off and go, "But I'm not that Jewish." And then everybody would have that response.
That's a good, Zachary Mulder.
Yeah, and then from there, I developed this guy, Ralph Handel, who was somebody who was Handel with an H.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
So yeah, essentially, he was this kind of this businessman who desperately wanted his life to be interesting. And he would see all these stand-up comedians go up and talk about their lives, and he's like, "Hey, I could do that too." You know, and he would just go on, and he'd be like, "Hey, everybody, big movie out this weekend, Wish. How many of you have seen it?" Woo! "How many?" "Two." "How do I know?" "Just counted." So after I saw the movie, I would...
Wow. Wow.
Yeah, so it was really this kind of intense thing. And I don't know
was
why.
Was it hard to get booked?
It was, actually.
Wow.
The thing is I started out at bringer shows, which I don't know if anybody knows that, but there's kind of a trajectory you go on as a stand-up comedian. You start as a bringer show and you bring your friends. They have to buy two drink minimum, all that stuff.
Yeah.
And then I started out doing that as Zach Mulden, and then I kind of developed a new act as Ralph Handel. I started doing that in college, too. And I was really proud because I elevated from bringer to still at the bringer show, but I didn't have to bring friends. So that was like a big deal for me. And it was like I was like making it in a lot of ways. And I guess it was kind of amazing. At one point, I got a phone call out of the blue, and I was like, "Oh my God, I've made it. You know, this is me at my big stand-up moment." They called me from a 212 number, and this is at Stand Up New York. I would do it at Gotham. I would do it at Comedy Cellar.
Yeah.
And I was kicked out of Comedy Cellar, actually. I'm not allowed to go back because Zach Mulden plays the guitar, but he doesn't know how to play the guitar. So I got really caught up in it. I was singing, I guess it was Some Guys Have All the Luck by Rod Stewart. And I was really into it. And I guess I went 5 minutes over.
Yeah.
And that's not okay.
No, you can't do that.
You can't do that. Yeah, so then that's probably why I created Ralph. So that I could go back into the clubs.
Okay, now I understand.
And so then...
Ralph is allowed.
Ralph is allowed now. Yeah. So I got a call, though, from Stand Up New York. They called me and they're like, "Hey, would Zach be willing to come on the show?" And like they gave me the time, like, "Oh, great." And I have to be in character. That's the thing. I'm obsessed with realism, and I would go into these performances, and I wanted everybody to believe I was actually that person.
Yeah.
So in a weird way, I guess it was like an acting exercise, too, mixed in with trying to express myself.
Yeah.
I don't know. But then they called me as Zach. I go on. Then as I'm getting ready to go, like I'm getting all my stuff ready, they call me from a 917 number. And they say, "Hey, is Ralph there?" And I'm like, "Oh my God, I gotta switch it up and now I gotta be Ralph Handel." And so I answer the phone as Ralph, like, "Hey, it's me, Ralph. How do I know? I just picked up the phone," that kind of thing. And then they booked
me. That's Ralph's humor.
Yes, they booked me on the same night, both of my characters. So I'm like, what am I gonna do? How am I gonna get around this? And I decided, I've got it. I'll go on as Zach Mulden, and then I will do 3 minutes of the set, and then I would say, "Hey, everybody, I do impressions. This is my friend Ralph." And I stripped down to my underwear, slicked my hair back, put on a whole bunch of cologne, dressed myself in a suit, put on the Bluetooth, and then I just did a 3.5 minute set as Ralph Handel.
Wow.
Stripped back out of the underwear, and as I stripped back, I heard everybody in the club go, "Oh,
Yeah, like this whole thing.
That guy's the same.
Yeah, they're like, this is who's been doing this to us for 4 years.
I love you. And I was just like, I love that you put cologne on.
Yeah, I don't know why.
Your character.
I would like turn away and just like pour Aqua Velva, you know, so. Because you gotta smell a certain way, right? If you're that person. It did.
It worked.
It worked, but then I kind of went back into Zach and then left, and then they never invited me back.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, so.
Well, here you are as Benny Safdie, and congratulations on everything you've done.
Yeah.
I want to talk about The Curse.
Yes, yes.
It's a fantastic premise. It's a fantastic, well-performed show. Explain how you came up with the idea.
So, I guess I had been an admirer of Nathan, you know, for his show, Nathan For You.
Nathan For You is brilliant.
Well deserved. You know, yeah. I really loved his work, and it was just kind of, he contacted us after he had seen some of our movies, you know, me and my brother, and then I met with him, just myself, and it was just like, oh, I had a good time. And the next time I was in LA, I was like, hey, you know what, I should reach out to that guy, you know. I had a fun time in New York, let's see if it goes bi-coastal. And it was really just kind of trying to be friends, you know? I just wanted to get to know him. And as we were talking about his first time in LA, he said, I went to go buy a cell phone because I had a Canadian phone. And on my way to the store, somebody said, hey, can you spare some change? And he's like, I'm sorry, I don't have anything. And they looked at him and said, I curse you. And he was just like, huh, that's strange. And he went on his way to the cell phone store, and it bothered him. You know, there was something about being cursed that was really just not nice.
Yeah.
And so and he decided to go to an ATM, take out some money, and then he went back to the place where the person was, gave them the money, and asked, is the curse lifted? And they said yes, with a smile on their face. And I immediately said, well, what if they weren't there? You know, then what? Your whole life is over because now you've got this curse and there's nothing you could do about it, right? Anything that happens to you can be attributed to that thing.
That moment.
And that moment. And so that was the kernel of it. And then also, at the time, we were both interested in realism and reality TV. You know, I think I'll come at it from more of a fiction side, trying to make fiction very real, and he'll make real life feel like fiction.
Yeah.
And so it's kind of a perfect marriage. But we realized we knew we wanted to talk about the reality TV area. And I, at the time, had been obsessed with HGTV. Obsessed, you know, I would go to the doctor with my wife for our first son, and I would sit in the waiting room, and I would just watch this stuff. And I became obsessed with Property Hunters, House Hunters.
Fixer Upper.
Fixer Upper, Flip or Flop, you know, all of these ones. And you kind of, as you're in this weird mode, you start paying attention to the people who are the hosts, what are their problems. And there were some behind the scenes stuff that I started seeing where the kids were involved and they didn't know. And there was all these things. And one time, I remember I was on the plane going to see Nathan because we were gonna do some more work on the show. And I saw the tagline for HGTV and it said, if you don't like your neighborhood, change it. And I was just like,
what?
Whoa. That was unexpected.
It's a little,
you know, so I was just
a little
like,
extreme there.
Yeah, so I was like, maybe you could, there's something there, you know? And then we just kind of dove in. And then that's kind of where the show came to be, you know?
And Emma Stone.
And Emma Stone, who's one of the most incredible.
It's fantastic. Gets it, gets the joke.
Gets it. And I have to say, I think it's one of the greatest performances I've ever seen, just because it's crazy to see her as Whitney, because she's operating on such a crazy high level.
Yes.
Because that character is really complicated, and in any place, she's constantly thinking about five different people who may talk to her, and, oh, I have to be this way with you, this way with this person, this way with this person, this way with this person.
Yeah.
And that's a lot to take on as an actor.
It's brilliant.
Just destroys, and I don't know, it was a lot of fun to do it, the three of us together, and there's a whole meta level that you can get to, like all three of us going down to Española, New Mexico, and making this show, and I don't know, it was an awesome experience together.
Congrats on the great reviews. I want to show everyone a clip. Here's Benny Safdie in The Curse. Take a look at this.
Look, you can go crime for crime if you want, right? Because I don't care. My life's over, essentially. Anyways, looks like a young boy wants to go to college, right? I don't think a college is going to want a criminal record on there, all right? So you think about that, because the only school he's gonna be able to get into is Albuquerque Community College, all right? I hear they have a good janitor program.
Calvin, do you know where your car is?
Cleaning up for the rest of his life. Excuse my language.
Do you know where your car is? Thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome. You're welcome. I appreciate the thank you, but you're welcome.
Thank you.
I'd like a thank you from him, please.
Thank you.
You're welcome, all right? But my morning is already ruined, okay? Believe it or not, I have a job to do. I'm a TV producer, okay? And my show just got picked up for 10 episodes to series.
Benny Safdie, everybody! New episodes of The Curse are available Fridays on the Paramount Plus app with Showtime. Hey, hey.